They get to watch me and Jake go out there and make this shit official. Last time, you know, there was some doubt on his fan side and my fan side, and now we get to go out there and get it on.
Torrin, you're stepping in on late notice.
This ain't late notice to y'all. This is late notice to them. This is destiny to me. I've already been ready. So you'll see Saturday. You're going to be the one huffing and puffing and running again.
How important is like manifesting these kinds of things? Because you've known for a while. You felt like this fight was going to happen. How important is it for a fighter?
It's been some times in my strike force and UFC career where I had some big, big fights that came up. And they said, Torrin, can you step in and fill in this for the fight? And I was out of shape. And I wasn't ready. And I was sitting back and eating fucking greasy late night munchy food. But this time I was ready. I was excited. You know, Nikisa, I don't know where he at, but he'll tell you, he couldn't even finish the sentence before I was in. So I'm excited for my team. They like instant oatmeal when I call my coach, without even a shadow of doubt, with no card on the, no fight card on the books, he was in St. Louis. We were training. He didn't ask no questions.
Torrin.
Oh, cool. Thank you, my man. Appreciate it.
Now, obviously this fight, you had Floyd assistance in the last fight. Did Floyd and you reach out and talk?
Yeah,
about
I mean, Floyd is a busy dude, man. I don't need him in the gym with me every single day, you know. GT is training him. So if he's qualified to train the best boxer of all times, I think that makes him qualified. So that's why I'm putting some respect on GT's name. Gerald Tucker's one of the best trainers out there. I train myself. He's training Clarissa Shields now. Yep. Javonte Davis is training them, Adrian Broner. So his attention to detail, his ability to understand boxing and understand you and learn you as a fighter, not just about your skills and what power punches you can throw, but what makes you tick, what gets you motivated, and also what distracts you, and trying to minimize those things where you can clearly think about the fight. So I'm really blessed and I'm thankful to have him in my corner. Like I said before, we've been training since the end of September, you know, so this ain't nothing new, you know, and our relationship is better, and the things that would have gotten me the victory, even without no knockdown, no 10-8 rounds, that would have got me in the victory in the last fight, we've already been working those things before they even asked me about the fight.
You got the tattoo.
Yeah.
How much of a motivation is that, looking at it every single day, to work with Jake Paul's ass?
I mean, it's not really a motivator. It's a part of the story. Like, I watch some of my peers walk around with some dumbass shit tattooed on their face and they gotta live with it at 80 years old. So for me, it's like, it's just a reminder of what we did, what we created. I never looked at the fight until about a week ago when All Access was coming in to do shoot the All Access shit, and I never saw how many people was there. I never saw how crazy and how electric the fucking arena was, and this is a part of the story. So at the end of the day, it's almost gone, by the way. So I don't have to look at it too much longer, and when I go out there and knock his ass out on Saturday, I'm not even going to trip off the tattoo.
When did you get the injury?